Hey there, comic fam. Welcome back to Climbing Comics. In today's sesh, we'll be talking about the first appearance of John Constantine. Hey there again, comic fam. Welcome back to Climbing Comics. So in today's sesh, I wanted to continue my deep dive into first appearances of lesser known characters. I'll be going over John Constantine, who is a little bit more well known because of Matt Ryan from the TV show and Keanu Reeves from the movie's portrayal of this character. There are two partial first appearances, and what I'll be going over today is his full first appearance. His partial first appearances were in Saga of Swamp Thing number 25, coming out in June 1984, followed by DC Sampler number 3, coming out in November of 1984 as well. What we'll be talking about today is Saga of Swamp Thing number 37, coming out in June 1985, written by Alan Moore, and inked by, and the art by, Rick Vitek and John Totleben. So, some background on this. So what you'll see is there's the portrayal of John Constantine is essentially someone that looks like Sting, right? So in a 1992 Wizard interview of Alan Moore, I think they asked him why he essentially looked like Sting. So this was a challenge from two of the artists, Steve Bissett and John Totleben, essentially to have someone look like Sting and kind of see if Alan Moore could kind of build a story around this. So Alan Moore was like, all right, a lot of the mystics in this time of comic books were essentially not essentially like street level type heroes or, you know, type of characters. So what he wanted to do is he wanted someone streetwise, someone working class, and someone essentially like a blue collar mystic, essentially. So that's where John Constantine grew out of, right? So this is how we start off. What I want to let you know a little bit about this book is that the Saga of Swamp Thing book number 37 was really fun in terms of how the story was told. So John Constantine as well as the Swamp Thing story are both like independent of each other, and then they start mixing with each other, right? So I want to give a disclaimer here before I start. There are definitely some disturbing images in this book. So like, you know, if you are of the faint of heart in terms of what you like to read, this is a little bit darker, right? So let's start her off. So essentially from the very first page, you see like a little seed in front of this can starting to sprout. And essentially in the next couple panels, you see Alec Honnold's love interest, Abigail or Abby, just kind of eating essentially, right? So that's day one. Day two, you see this sprout kind of growing a little bit more, but then you switch to John Constantine's story. So John Constantine visits his friend Judith. So essentially what John Constantine is trying to do, he's going around consulting different mystics for something oncoming, some oncoming crisis essentially. So he goes to her, she's kind of in this seedy like bar or club, and essentially, you know, there's illicit drugs, there's alcohol, and she's probably not in the right state of mind, but she's essentially telling John Constantine, there's a scientific source behind this, you don't need to have to worry about it, right? Hey, I want to be left alone. Essentially, we have about a year before this thing comes, so don't bother me. Just like, let's just get this going. You jump back a little bit to Swamp Thing. So he's growing a little bit more and more, and he's starting to gain some consciousness. He realizes, hey, I'm Swamp Thing. I'm growing. There's all of this stuff around me. Let me continue to nourish myself and grow a little bit, right? So that's essentially day three of Swamp Thing knowing who he is, right? He's starting to sleep and he's starting to grow, and you see Abigail kind of walking around with a flashlight, and she finally finds him. Somehow he calls out to her. So switch back. Constantine goes to visit his friend Benjamin, who lives with his mother, and essentially his friend is saying that what's coming is going to come in about a year, but he thinks it's something like Cthulhu. So this is from, I think, H.P. Lovecraft stories, Cthulhu, and he has like this calendar that kind of goes with this, and he's like saying, he's basically confirming, yeah, we have about 12 months before this this bad thing comes, or this bad thing awakens. Next day, day six, since Abigail found Swamp Thing. You know, she's taking a water bucket, she's watering him, making sure he grows, and you kind of see that she sprays like insecticide on him just because there's stuff around. And it's funny because there's these little blurbs of Swamp Thing's thoughts, and he's essentially like, oh my god, I'm glad I didn't grow any full eyes right now because they would have been damaged since she's just spraying pesticides on me. I guess I should grow a mouth and vocal cords so I could tell her to stop this. So next day, day 7, she finds like something like on his head, and now he's starting to look a little bit like a cross between Baby Groot and Baby Yoda. So it's pretty funny because like he's grown a little bit of vocal cords and he's able to essentially say like, Abby, no more sprays, no more sprays. And then so she's like, oh, well, pardon me, I'm just the one watering you here. So it's funny, you kind of see Abigail kind of having like this kind of funny demeanor around him. The next day, you kind of see day 8. So Swamp Thing just looks like a mini version of Swamp Thing at this point. And I'll definitely show a picture here. It's pretty good. You cut back to Constantine, who's now visiting like this nun, his sister. Not his like biological sister, but a sister who's like taking care of children. So she also confirms that something is going to come in 12 months, but she thinks that it's Satan, right? So now we have, this is nothing scientific from Judith. We have from his friend Benjamin, Cthulhu, and now this is going to be Satan from this nun. So she also confirms it's about 12 months. So Constantine's like, all right, well, I got to go take care of this. Next day, day 9, it's pretty funny. You see like the bust of Swamp Thing growing out of the ground because he hasn't regrown the rest of his body yet. And, you know, he's just like hanging out with Abby. And it's funny because he tries to speak, but she essentially makes fun of him because he kind of sounds like Jiminy Cricket. And she just starts laughing. But it's so sweet because, you know, his eyes are red, and then you kind of see Swamp Thing kind of just see the silhouette and like the outline of Abby, and he calls her beautiful, but she just makes fun of him because of his voice. So this is kind of nice. They're like, you know, they're just kind of rekindling their relationship. You kind of see her bring some wine over. She creates a fire near him. Like, it's really just a bust of his body out of the ground, and she's just walking around hanging out, and it's pretty fun. So he essentially is like, oh, this is all new to me. I'm just trying to grow. Like, how long will this be? And he's thinking about maybe 4 days until his full body grows and he could walk. And then, they have a romantic moment. They kiss and whatnot. And then they hug. So next day, day 11, you see John Constantine at his friend's house. He wakes up and starts talking about Cthulhu and all of these different things that are going on. Emma is drawing like this kind of weird monster type thing on her art board. John Constantine's just drinking his coffee and just trying to figure out how he could bring down what he needs to bring down in 1 year, essentially. Day 12. This panel was really cool. It's like different cross sections of Swamp Thing where essentially he's like trying to figure out like what he is and how he's regrowing, because he died essentially, or someone poisoned him in a previous issue, and he's essentially coming back. Day 13, you see that John Constantine left his friend Emma to go down to Louisiana to find Swamp Thing, and this is where the stories intertwine. He's one of those kind of weird dudes that kind of appears in the back of Abby's car, and he's like, how's the boyfriend? And then she's like all shocked. And then so essentially he tells her like he knows so much about her and Alec. So Abby brings him to Swamp Thing. And then, of course, just like Constantine is as we know him today, he basically tries to like con him essentially. So it's funny because he's like, I know more about you, mate, than you know about yourself. And Swamp Thing's like, what are you talking about? So you kind of start to see a little bit of a, like, what John Constantine knows about him. Essentially, he's like, did you realize that you could dissolve yourself in one place and then regrow yourself in a completely different place? And essentially, like, transport yourself wherever you want to, where there's any plant life, and you could just do that instantly. And then so Swamp Thing is now intrigued, and he's like, tell me more, tell me more. Constantine is basically not being like really nice, and he's essentially like, all right, if you really want to learn about this stuff, in about a week I'll be outside of Chicago in this town called Rosewood, and so if you want to know more about yourself, come and meet me there. Now you kind of jump back to Emma, and you see like her painting that she drew this monster on is now blank. And then so it's a little bit weird. And you kind of see her walk away. You kind of see her drop this mug. And what happens at this point is like every one of John Constantine's friends, from Judith to Benjamin to the nun, are all going crazy. So, you know, Judith, I guess she's like kind of went over the edge with all of like the drugs and alcohol she has. Benjamin is starting to speak in tongues. His mom tries to get something that he could bite on so he doesn't bite off his tongue. And then you start to see the nun start to like take one of the kids' dolls and kind of rip its head a little bit. It's kind of crazy because at the same time, Emma is like hallucinating or something. She sees something. She opens a door, and essentially the monster that she drew came to life. And this is really gruesome looking thing. So definitely disclaimer, I'm going to show the picture here, but this is kind of a something you might not want to see. And then so you see these panels of all of his friends kind of going crazy because of something bad that's happening. So it's kind of sad because like his friend Emma essentially jumps out of her window to her death, unfortunately. You see Judith kind of going over that edge, and then like Benjamin's mom just trying to stick that spoon in her son's mouth, and the nun just like totally ripping off the doll's head of this kid. And so essentially all of this bad stuff is happening after John Constantine had left Swamp Thing and Abby. And then so this is day 17 now. This is a couple days later. So Swamp Thing is completely out of the ground. And, you know, Abby's trying to make light of the situation, saying like things like, I miss the days when I was actually taller than you, because he was like kind of growing in the ground. He's sitting down, hand on his face, and she's like, well, isn't it time for a honeymoon? Like, should we just go to that lake that we talked about before? What do you think? And then all that Swamp Thing could say is Rosewood. I think I know Rosewood from somewhere. Swamp Thing was not listening to her at all. And she's just like crying, and she's like, nothing. It's nothing. So that's essentially how this book ends. It's a pretty interesting book. I could tell like with the storyline from Alan Moore, from like all the issues before this to all the issues after this, there's gonna be a compelling story here. So the story of Constantine, you could kind of see the fact that, like, you know, he's part of this occult community. And definitely watch some of the Variant Comics YouTube videos to get a little bit more background on Constantine. But like, there's different storylines of like his history, how he got to be where he is today, like his family, how he got into magic, and kind of how he's kind of that anti-hero, essentially, like the hero that wants to save people, but like as they said in that show, he's kind of like rough around the edges. I think that this is a really good very first issue of John Constantine. I think this is a fun book to have and read if you like that type of character. So if with this information, I feel like you definitely can make a decision on whether you want Swamp Thing number 25, Saga Swamp Thing number 37, which is what we went over today, or DC Sampler number 3, or maybe you want all three. So there's a lot of good story here. So, you know, if you want to hear more about lesser known characters, please write in the comment section below who you want to hear about, because I definitely want to hear about some of the characters that you guys are interested in. So definitely, if you like this type of content, please give that thumbs up, click that subscribe button, and click that bell icon so you're notified of when I come out with new content. This is a fun read. Let's keep it going. So from my comic journey to yours, make it your own. Thanks all. Bye.